Okay, but I have my vasectomy today. So I need to be back in a few hours to catch my ride to the doctor's. My neighbor is driving me because my wife's out of town with the girls.
Why don't I drive you?
I don't know. I guess I didn't really think of you as that kind of friend.
Sarge, I'm every kind of friend. I'm Phoebe, I'm Chandler, I'm Rachel, I'm... Who's the dinosaur guy?
Ross, bro! Ross!
Sorry, I forgot. You were such a Ross head. So look, we'll work this thing together, and afterwards, I will be your friend chariot to the penis removal of the century.
Here you go!
Woo! Woo! Dude, your head is so small. No, it's so small! Where do you keep your brains?
Oh, good. All right, got your PJs on, read you a story, checked under the bed for monsters.
Check again.
And now it's sleepy time, so here we go, getting on.
Wait. You gotta promise me you won't let them give me the operation. I wanna have more kids. I don't want the vasectomy. Promise me, tiny head. Promise me.
All right, I promise.
Good. Yeah. 'Cause I'm not done with my testicles yet. I'm gonna let them see.
Hey, oh. Sarge, wait up. Come on, don't be mad. Look, I'm only trying to protect you from your very stupid self.
That is enough, Jake.
Look, I'm sorry, okay? But the things you said when you were whacked out were real. You made me promise, and as your friend...
I told you, Jake, we're not that kind of friends.
Not what kind of friends?
Friends. You and I are work friends. Now, if you will excuse me, I'm going to the doctor's office.
Not good enough. Prepare to be physically overpowered by a friend.
Cancel the appointment. I've got you.
You can't move. Concede defeat, sir. You have been conquered.
You better not be trying to talk me out of my surgery again.
Look, I'm not trying to talk you out of anything. I'm just here to give you a ride home and to prove to you once and for all that I'm more than just a work friend.
Thank you, microscope head.
Hey, a little bit of good news. I figured out the case. Remember Gregory said he got off at the York Street station the night of the stabbing? Well, I took the subway here and it's closed for construction.
So what you're saying is, I stabbed him. I did it. I'm sorry I thought of you as a work friend. You're here, man. You're a friend. You made Terry get real with himself and his genitals. Your tiny head has a big heart inside it.
I know that's scientifically wrong, but thanks, Arch.
I'm gonna talk to my wife when she comes home. You're a huggy, good boy.
No! Not again.
He is so strong, but so gentle. He's like an enormous, muscular Ellen DeGeneres.
You know what? I just want to let you guys know that I love you girls so, so much. Okay, so sleep tight. You know, Daddy will never leave you, right, girls? Rock-a-bye, baby.
Gosh, really makes you understand what he went through.
I'm worried about Terry. We can't let anything bad happen to him.
So, what's the plan at the gym?
I say we slow play it, you know? Do a little more setup, a little surveillance, wait a couple months and see if they turn themselves in.
Listen, man, I know everybody's worried about me being psychologically ready for this, but I promise you I am. No matter what happens, no matter how many bullets are flying, I'm gonna be right there in the middle of everything. I got your back.
No, it's not even that, you know? It's just... Well, frankly, I'm not so sure that everyone at the gym is going to buy you as a trainer. You've been sitting behind that desk for so long, you've gotten a little tubby, right? It's like love handle alert. Do you have a bone there somehow?
Jake, I promise, I'm good. Oops. I gotta put this stuffed giraffe between my two girls. They both like to snuggle against his head. Huh? Here comes Mr. Snuggles! Here comes Mr. Snuggles!
Again, Sarge, it's so good to see you. Just out of curiosity, how did you find out about this?
I'm a detective sergeant in the NYPD. Holt told me. Why are you cutting me out of the operation?
What? That's crazy. Boyle, come in here and stand in front of my body and tell him that's crazy. Ow, my lucky face!
You gonna talk to me now?
Sure, if you could be any vacation. Oh! You didn't let me finish. If you could be any vacation, What would you be? I'd be skiing.
Oh, now I'm gonna hit you for real.
That wasn't for real? Oh my God. No, wait, I was worried.
Worried about what?
About you getting hurt. I don't want your daughters growing up without a dad. I know what that's like, and it sucks. And I don't want it to happen to them.
Why didn't you just say something to me?
Because I didn't want to get in your head and have you freak out again.
Well, I get it. It's been a rough year. But I've learned to embrace my fears. It makes me a better cop.
Tax 1 and 2 are set. 30 minutes until the bogeys arrive.
Thanks, Boyle. I love it when you say bogeys. So we good?
We good. Well, for the record, if I could be any kind of vacation, I'd be lake trip.
Classic.
You gonna let me do this, man?
What choice do I have? You hit me in the arm so hard they no longer work.
All right. It's time to catch some bad guys. It's good to be back.
Have a fun steroid deal, Sergeant.
You're a weird guy, Jake.
Yeah.
The Ebony Falcon.
No. The Ebony Falcon had no fear. He's the Ebony Antelope now. Brave enough to drink at the lake, but wise enough to run from the lions. Hey, my arms don't work. Can you scratch my nose?
You bet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you. Morning, Captain.
So, how did Sergeant Jeffords do?
Why is everyone so worried about the Sarge? He was amazing. He made the buy, took out the suppliers, but wisely didn't take on more than he could handle.
I left one for you.
And you'll be happy to know that he punched me in the face several times.
That does make me happy.
Guess we're being candid today. Hey, Sarge, just for the record, I hope you're on every case with me for the rest of my career. I'm not scared for you at all. Love you a lot.
Thanks, Jake. Oh, Peralta. I almost forgot. My girls made you a card to thank you for keeping me safe.
Oh. You're so full of potential. Why would you show me this?
What's going on, Peralta? Charles says you're gonna make me happier than I was on my wedding night.
Well, that's not how I would have put it, but I know you were mad at me for ruining Glooper time, so I did all your paperwork.
That's not helpful. You always make 1,000 mistakes.
Mm-hmm. That's what Amy said as well, right before she took over for me, so it's perfect.
Okay. Hey, thanks, man. I appreciate it.
And I spoke with Sharon. I spoke with Captain Holt, and we all agreed that you deserve a break. So, this weekend, Charles and I are taking you to the great outdoors. To Detective Lohank's cabin.
Boom. Suck it, wedding night.
Lohank? That sad sack? All he does is talk about his wife sleeping with other men.
No, he also has some great stories about his prostate cancer.
Besides, he's not sticking around. It's just the three of us.
Those woods are full of ticks. It's Lyme disease central.
So we'll get some bug spray.
Plus, that cabin's probably covered in black mold.
Racist.
You know what? I am gonna stay home and have a blooper bath.
Oh, come on, Sarge. It's gonna be fun. You remember fun, right?
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. It's just, I planned this awesome guy's weekend for us and all you can think about is Lyme disease.
Untrue. I'm thinking about all tick-borne diseases. Anaplasmosis, tularemia, Rocky Mountain spotted fever. You know, maybe I could just chill out a little.
Yes, you're stressed. A little fun would do you good, I promise.
You know what? You're right. You all better get ready for Fun Terry.
Ooh, Fun Terry. He sounds fun.
No, he's crazy. Thanks for planning this, Jake.
No, thank you for being amazing. And also for driving us up to the cabin. My car's in the shop and riding in Charles's is like sitting inside of a dog's bahonkus. Fun Terry, can't wait. Hey, Sarge. Why'd you want us to meet you out here?
To thank you guys for the weekend.
Really? It was a total disaster.
Not a total disaster. None of us got sick from that dog water.
You drank that?
No.
Look, Jake, you were right. I have kind of forgotten how to have fun. I'm gonna try to work on that, so...
The fireworks you made me surrender when we re-entered New York!
Uh-huh. Fun Terry's back. We're gonna set them off in a big pile all at once.
By shooting our guns at them?
What? No.
No.
We're gonna set them off like normal people.
Oh, that's good too.
Ooh.
Here we go. Woo-hoo! See how fun this is? Original Terry would have been worried that we're standing too close and need safety goggles, and he would have been absolutely right. We're way too close for us!